Off a busy street, a North Edmonton family has created the Garden Gallery.
Like, supposed to support. It makes people feel happy and feel love.
But when Augustus Wreikkinen went to check the front yard art gallery Monday, he found this letter promoting anything but love, sharing anti-LGBTQ2S+ rhetoric.
She read the letter with our son. He was the first one to read it. He crumpled the letter up. He threw it out. We did retrieve it because it was actually evidence in what I consider a hate crime.
Security footage shows a man biking up to the Garden Gallery Monday around 3 a.m. At the request of the Wreikkinens, we've blurred the suspect's face so as not to interfere with the police investigation. But it appears he has a large stack of papers in his bag. Since sharing on social media,
people took the opportunity to say that they've been experiencing the same thing for up to a year.
What goes through my mind is, like again?
Down the street, the same letter was found on Metropolitan Rockabilly Hair Design Monday. Not surprising for owner Victoria Stevens, who's received similar literature numerous times. She thought it was because she strives to have an inclusive salon.
Pull it up and throw it away because I've read the same thing numerous times over and over again. But then I get thinking that, like, you know, people who are part of the LGBTQ2S community and how harmful this could be for somebody who is maybe already struggling or has a history of trauma.
Now that Stevens knows it's happening to others, she'll report it to police if it happens again. Edmonton police saying they've only received one formal complaint at this time, and it's under investigation.
About this hate against pride, against anyone else, and that we have to stand for those people that are being knocked down.
The Wreikkinens will continue to fly their pride flag and show support to other communities facing trauma or oppression. The whole Garden Gallery inspired by Augustus.
I just want to tell the people that we've got your backs and we love you.
Hoping the message that you matter shines brightest. In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.